whenever we are observing hand, wrist and hand for deformities, remember, deformities give an idea of the disorders, whenever it comes to wrist and hand. Colis fracture, distal radius, which can either be the volar displacement or the Smith fracture, which is the dorsal displacement of the distal end of radius. Remember, the palm can come to a dorsally displaced position compared to the forearm. That means the forearm is here, palm can be here. That is called as dinner fork deformity. Okay? So, dinner fork deformity, like how the fork comes like this. Okay, bent. The same way, the wrist also appears, dinner fork deformity. And then, rheumatoid arthritis can cause an ulnar drift in the wrist also. That is, the ulnar deviation of the wrist. Okay? Ulnar drift in the wrist means, it's an ulnar deviated position of the wrist. Rheumatoid arthritis. Next, coming to further thumb. Usually you see that thumb is facing medially. It's rotated. Thumb is not in the plane of the other fingers. Other fingers flex and extend in sagittal plane. Thumb flexes and extends in the coronal or the frontal plane. If the thumb is adducted and laterally rotated, then it comes in the plane of the other fingers. This is similar to the ape thumb. Because the apes, they use the upper limb for walking, locomotion. So the thumb is laterally rotated. Ape thumb deformity comes because of atrophy and weakness of opponent's pollicis. Opponent's pollicis is responsible for opposition movement where the thumb can touch the other fingers. Okay? So when opponent's pollicis is supplied by the median nerve. So median nerve injury, opponent's pollicis weakness leading to ape thumb deformity. Okay? Cuts in the thumb. And then the next one, extensor pollicis longus. The long muscle which is getting inserted into the distal phalanx of the thumb. If that gets ruptured, avulsion fracture or tendon rupture, then interphalangeal joint of the thumb will be flexed because of unopposed action. Extensor pollicis longus is ruptured. Then over a period of time, the metacarpophalangeal joint goes into extension. So metacarpophalangeal goes into extension, interphalangeal joint goes into flexion. This is the mallet thumb. Okay? Similar situation in the other fingers, distal phalanx, extensor digitorum going for a rupture, distal phalanx goes into flexion, and over a period of time the proximal interphalangeal joint goes into extension. And then the MCP, metacarpophalangeal, also goes into flexion. So you have MCP flexion, PAP extension and DAP flexion. So mallet finger starts from distal interphalangeal joint and then progresses to proximal interphalangeal and then the metacarpophalangeal. Whereas the same deformity position, if it starts from metacarpophalangeal and then proximal interphalangeal joint extension and distal interphalangeal joint flexion, it becomes a swan neck deformity. Swan neck deformity happens in rheumatoid arthritis. Whereas mallet finger happens because of an avulsion fracture, which is happens sometimes in goalkeepers, okay, because the ball hits the finger during a forced extension. Forceful extension is performed, at the same time if something hits the tip of the finger into flexion, the avulsion fracture can happen. Okay? And then next one, opposite of swan neck deformity. Swan neck deformity was, you have flexion here, extension in the PAP and flexion in the DAP. This is the swan neck deformity. So that is indirectly, if you see, here flexion, here extension and again here flexion. This is swan neck deformity. Opposite of this, you extend here, PAP flexion, DAP extension. Okay? So the hand will become like this. extended MCP, flexed PIP and extended DIP. So here again, extended, this is flexed. Okay. So from the lateral view, you can see this is MCP extended, PIP flexed and DIP extended. This is Wattenaer deformity. Wattenaer deformity. This also happens in rheumatoid arthritis. Okay. And then next, coming to the fingers, you have intrinsic plus deformity. Intrinsic plus is in the action of the intrinsic muscles, the lumbricals and the intraossei. MCP is flexed in 90 degree. IP joints are extended. In the same position, it can go into ulnar drift, where all the fingers are deviated towards the medial side. Okay. Intrinsic minus, intrinsic plus happens in rheumatoid arthritis. Okay. In intrinsic minus, it's because of nerve injuries. Okay. Nerve injuries leading to paralysis or weakness of the intrinsic muscles. Opposite of intrinsic plus will come. The deformity is called as intrinsic minus. What happens is MCP gets into extension and then IP joints go into flexion. Okay. So MCP extended. Okay. You can see the perfect deformity here. MCP extended and then IP joint is flexed. The typical situation here, all the four fingers, they are going into a intrinsic minus position, is called as the total claw hand. Only if medial fingers are going into clawing and the lateral ones are normal, it's called as the median claw hand, because median nerve injury leads to only the lateral lumbricals going for atrophy. So it will affect that. The here lumbricals are intact. If it is ulnar nerve injury and median nerve is intact, only the median lumbricals, the two lumbricals will go for atrophy, which will lead to the claw hand, which is only in the little finger and in the ring finger. Okay? In the little finger and ring finger, the extension of the MCP with the flexion of the IP joints will happen. So this medial side claw hand is there. It's called as the ulnar claw hand. Otherwise also called as the bishop's hand deformity. Okay? It's the position of the hand of the bishop in or the priest in the church. And then next, together, if you see a deformity in the thumb also, a thumb, and then you see a total claw hand also. Okay, total claw hand and an a thumb. Okay, together. Then you can suspect that median nerve injury, ulnar nerve injury, because of total claw hand and a thumb. With the associated with what is called as wrist drop. Wrist drop happens because of the radial nerve, palsy or the injuries. So if all the three nerves are affected, it's affected in the condition triple nerve palsy, leprosy. So various conditions cause various deformities. Right from the thumb deformities of a thumb, or mallet thumb, finger deformities, mallet finger, and then we see for swan neck, Wattenaer deformity, okay, and then next one, intrinsic plus, intrinsic minus. In intrinsic minus, median claw hand, ulnar claw hand, total claw hand, okay, in the intrinsic minus, and in the wrist, ulnar drift. Wrist can be with wrist drop. Okay? Both the presentations can come. If there is fracture, police fracture, after that there is a malunion, then you might get a dinner for deformities. Okay? All these are common. In addition to this, sometimes you will rarely find a proximal interphalangeal joint. Proximal phalanx is proper. Middle phalanx will be abducted. Okay? It will be like bent away. It may be because of injury of collateral ligaments over a long period of time. Childhood injury was there, after that the ligament and the capsule got adapted and the person grows up. In adulthood you will find that the finger is deviated at the proximal phalanx or at the distal phalanx. There is no specific name for that. But those are all either valgus instability or varus instabilities. Okay? So the finger also can be getting fixed in the PAP joint, abducted or adducted positions. So that's another thing to watch out for. In other than that, the observation, you will see for TNR muscles whether there is any atrophy. If there is atrophy, there will be creases in the middle of the TNR muscles. Okay? If there is no atrophy, the muscle bulk will be full. TNR, hypoTNR also, you can examine for the same for the atrophy. Intrasai, palmar intrasai anteriorly and the dorsal intrasai posteriorly. Okay? In between the metacarpals. Okay? If there is too much of bothering, you can tell it's atrophy. Adductor pollicis felt posteriorly. Okay? Adduction. Resist the adduction. The adductor pollicis. Supplied by ulnar nerve. Okay? And there are various special tests also, almost similar to these things, to check various nerve function of the hand. So, deformity observation itself will give a clue on what likely conditions are affecting the patient's either upper limb. It can be even radiculopathies where the root value and then the muscles are C8T1. If it is thoracic outlet syndrome or Klumke's paralysis, brachial plexus injury, lower trunk, okay, then ulnar nerve will get affected. So the patients will have ulnar claw hand. Okay. Or even a cubital tunnel syndrome, ulnar claw hand. Okay? And here also Guyon's canal is there, pisiform, Guyon's canal. Ulnar nerve comes to the hand. That can also lead to ulnar claw hand if there is entrapment neuropathy, ulnar nerve here. Carpal tunnel syndrome usually leads to ape thumb. It will not lead to median claw hand. Over a period of time, it will lead to the median claw hand. Okay, that is carpal tunnel syndrome. These are all deformities, but sensory deficits will be in the distribution of the nerve. If there is a wrist drop, and posteriorly the sensory deficits will be there. Okay, deformities are caused because of the prolonged motor deficit, the muscles being weak. Okay? So observation gives a clue on accurate differential diagnosis for wrist and hand, and also sometimes pathologies in the elbow and shoulder or cervical spine. So, hand observation is very important for deformities.